And I believe that everything that we do, everything that we create, is nature expressing itself the same way that when a flower grows out of the ground or a tree grows out of the ground, it's nature expressing itself. And you might say that the tree is expressing itself by the way its branches move out, but it's the force that drives nature. That's the tree is the visible thing that appears to our senses. But we are able to make contact with that current. The creative force of the universe, or the source, or God, or whatever you want to call it, we're able to sort of connect with the intelligence of this by learning a musical language, learning a musical instrument, learning how to identify a sound and a feeling, and to be able to learn how to gradually express that feeling through an instrument. The idea of somebody considering themselves responsible for a piece of music is ridiculous. We're only acting into the laws of nature that have given us the possibilities that we're exploring with the intelligence that we've been given. Something like the frequency spectrum from low to high, that's what we're working with. That's here, whether we're here or not. It exists as part of the structure of physical reality. And our brains are learning to interact with it through learning an instrument, you know. Possibilities are presented in this kind of invisible, silent way. They're just there, you know. Sound and laws of acoustics are what they are. The frequency spectrum is what it is. The 12 note to the octave scale was just something waiting to be discovered, but which was already a mathematical possibility before Pythagoras. Pythagoras thought of it. Possible for one person to be in the right place at the right time in their life to create the things that they create, it has to do with a really complex structure of the mind and the soul and the nervous system and everything.